this episode of the Kościuszko Foundation series Artist in a Spotlight, we are visiting textile artist Agata Peszko, who lives in Arlington, Virginia, just outside of Washington, D.C. Agata invited us to view her artwork in her garden to emphasize her connections with nature. She creates three-dimensional wall hangings out of pure wool. Her interest in textile art started years ago in London, where she studied at the London College of Fashion, before she received her formal art education at the University in Krakow, Poland, where she was born and raised. She also studied graphic design and photography in Paris. Agata's unique wall hangings have been exhibited at the American Textile Museums and are part of many private collections. Agata's creativity goes much beyond fine arts, though. She also makes artistic clothing and jewelry. Today, we will chat with Agata about her work and her passion for wool.
Nice to meet you, Agata.
Nice to meet you, Isa.
Let's see what we have in here. Can I touch it?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. It's there to be touched. It's made with hands, so, you know, it's absolutely touchable.
So this is the scarf, or is it?
It could be. It could be, but it's a wall hanging as well, you know. So it really depends how you want to use it. And when it, you know, you have to kind of picture that in interiors. Mm-hmm. And when it is in, like, modern contemporary interior, it looks like an animal, basically, like a skin of animal. So, it, you know, it really translates a little bit differently in the different surrounding. So that this is how I want my art to be displayed. Usually it's, you know, within a contrast to modern spaces.
Do you have any particular name for your art pieces?
Not really, because, you know, I do a lot of stuff. So, you know, those are wall hangings, but I also do, you know, jewelry, stuff like that. So it's really... and we have COVID, so I have a mask here, but...
We are outdoors, so we are safe.
So, not really. It's just, this is wall hangings, and, you know, I work a lot with wall hangings, but recently with COVID I was sitting and just doing jewelry and stuff like that, just playing around.
And you have a blouse on
Yes. So, you know, with this medium you can actually produce anything. So I have as well a few dresses and jackets, but I am not focusing on, on producing clothes. But you can do it. Later on, you know, I show you, I have two hats over there, so it works like, you can actually sculpture wool to have like a 3D effect and build on that.
So. And you mentioned wool, right?
Yes.
It's felt, I think, right?
Yes. It's called, the name is felt, or it's a name for a specific process. Are you processing a specific way? And it's the most ancient way of processing textiles on the planet, around probably 5,000 years. And you use wool as we know, but we felt it, meaning like I use friction and water and soap and just press it together depending on what I would like to create. I work with that vision in my head and just try to.
Sounds like a very process-oriented medium.
Yes, it is.
How long does it take to actually create a felt?
It depends what, because if you have something lighter, you don't have to use that much force and friction. But for example, a piece like that, like over there, it takes few good days, and depending on how you work as well, you know, if the work is intense, it takes few days. So you have to kind of prop, you know, the materials, prop it in a way, and then you can reuse them. You create pre-felt, and then you felt again the pre-felt. So the process is kind of complex, and it really depends what you want to do with it. That's why it's very, you know, it's difficult to explain in one go. But basically, we start from wool over there,
from an animal skin.
So we start from this, we have it on the animal, this is how it looks like, and then we take, you know, we shave it, so that's how it is, right? and then we clean it, we wash it. Mm-hmm. You can actually, I work with those already. Mm-hmm. That's mm-hmm. good as well. Mm-hmm. I create some hanging pieces over there. I just mm-hmm. wool like that. Mm-hmm. And when it's clean, this is how it looks. Mm-hmm. And in order to create something mm-hmm. like that, for example, mm-hmm. you basically have to create textile. So you pull it mm-hmm. very thin layers and place it.
Oh.
And place it in a way that it will stick together.
Uh-huh.
So you can create something really thin like that, but if you put more wool and more layers, it'll be thicker. Right?
Wow, I didn't know the wool behaves this way, actually.
It yeah.
sticks together.
Yeah, I mean, right now it wouldn't be sticking together. You need to put water uh-huh. and soap.
But it still sticks a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, yeah. Right? Mm-hmm. But wool has this magical properties that it goes through mm-hmm. itself and stick. Like, you know, you put the sweater into your washing mm-hmm. machine. Mm-hmm. That's exactly the same process.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, that's why this is... People think that, you know... We actually felters, we buy felt mm-hmm. and just kind of, I don't know, sew it together. There's mm-hmm. no sewing in this piece.
Uh-huh.
It's just the whole thing made in one go.
Mm-hmm.
Together, I shape it and mm-hmm. I create the fabric in the same time.
I see.
Like that.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to have a vision what you want mm-hmm. in order to create it and have the effect
yes.
at the end. Because once it's felted,
mm-hmm.
it's done.
Yeah.
I mean, you can cut it and reuse it in other pieces, mm-hmm. but as for, you know, the piece that you want, mm-hmm. it's gone.
Mm-hmm.
So then you can, out of this, you can also create pieces like that
mm-hmm.
and put it on the wall as mm-hmm. well, you know, mm-hmm. so it can be like a mm-hmm. enormous piece,
uh-huh.
you know, on the wall.
Like a sculpture.
Yeah, mm-hmm. like very sculpt, and mm-hmm. you know, and it's actually in interiors to be able to touch something like that mm-hmm. is very therapeutic.
Mm-hmm.
Wool is very therapeutic.
Yes.
So that's basically more or less mm-hmm. that's it for the process mm-hmm. of creating it. But uh-huh. you have to have water and soap, usually mm-hmm. soap. But you know, there are different approaches.
Mm-hmm.
Some artists use only cold water and only natural materials.
Uh-huh.
I use everything. I just mix mm-hmm. whatever I need and mm-hmm. I have, I use. Mm-hmm. I am not Orthodox in that
mm-hmm.
way.
Mm-hmm. And I see this is natural color, and
yes.
you have this really bright, beautiful colors in here, blue
yes.
and red. How do you create this color?
Well, you just basically dye it.
Uh-huh.
So this one, mm-hmm. and it also depends what you want to create, mm-hmm. because this one was created out of already dyed wool.
Uh-huh.
This, for example,
uh-huh.
you know, it's like a sculpture.
Uh-huh. Yeah, this is beautiful.
So I mm-hmm. I keep it on my table,
uh-huh.
and my cats walk all over it. That's why it's a little bit.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, so
it's like it could be a centerpiece.
It, yes,
you could use it for like a
yeah.
fruit ball.
Mm-hmm,
even,
mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
This is so pretty.
And you can, you know, I put somewhere there. I put the bag
mm-hmm.
as well. So this bag also, like this piece that I'm wearing, it's created in one piece. So it's like a sculpture.
Uh huh. Uh-huh.
Wow. Right, I just
mm-hmm.
cut it here to be able to open
it there.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
but it's a sculpture basically.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, it can be even like, you know,
like a vase.
Yeah, like
for
a vase.
Flowers.
Yeah.
For like dry
so
flowers.
But I will have to use different wool for that
mm-hmm.
and work differently with
mm-hmm.
it in order to have
mm-hmm.
it stiff.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the
mm-hmm.
way I want.
Mm-hmm.
But everything is possible. That's why this is a very magical
mm-hmm.
magical medium.
Uh-huh. So you said this was. This was colored before.
Yes.
Uh-huh. And you use just different pieces in different colors,
yeah.
different pieces of felt, and you just use water to kind of...
Yes.
Sure.
So for this effect,
mm-hmm.
you create pre-felt.
Mm-hmm.
So everything here, I basically created, right?
Mm-hmm.
This piece,
mm-hmm.
I put it together
mm-hmm.
from the pieces
mm-hmm.
of wool,
mm-hmm.
which I lose.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then I cut it and, you know, and I just created the mosaic the way I
mm-hmm.
want to.
Mm-hmm.
And then you felt it again.
Mm-hmm.
So there are stages
mm-hmm.
with
this is beautiful.
Process.
Reminds me a little bit, there is this artist, Ibonecue. I'm not sure if you
mm-hmm.
know her, but she is so like black and white monochromatic, but you added so much color in it. I love it.
Yeah, and you know, and that's what surprised mm-hmm. me as well, because I usually am not, you know, that colorful, but sometimes wool brings
it's hard
up.
To believe looking at you.
I know it's really strange, you know, it's really strange because I don't picture myself, but you know, I sometimes see photos of myself wearing very colorful.
That's great.
Well, you know, it's like surprising. But you know, that's why art is so amazing. That, you know, you really like research within yourself, surprising things that you didn't know about yourself.
And the sound of airplane actually reminds us that we are in an urban environment. We are not. One would think that we are in the countryside. It's so beautiful here.
We are in the middle of Arlington.
Arlington, yes. It's hard to live with all the woods around you. And I love your display. Like, it's put on the trunk of the tree. It looks lovely.
Yeah. Those trees are amazing. Those are beautiful old trees.
Yeah, it looks really wonderful. I love the way you display it. And probably it's also good for them to air them every once in a while.
Sure, yeah.
Where do you keep them, and how do you see people displaying them at home?
Well, you know, people can display the way they want to, but, you know, depending on the piece, like if it's a sculpture, something you can put on the table, you can hang it on the wall, you know, that those pieces are usually hang on the wall. Mm-hmm. But you know, there's people are afraid of wool and textiles, but really there is no problem with it. If it hangs on the wall, you know, and you air them from time to time, you can even, you know, if you know what you're doing, you could probably wash it, because that's how it's done, with water, with cold water, so nothing should happen to it.
Very organic. I love the patterns, the designs. Tell me what inspires you.
So for this specific series, I had a series of that. Mm-hmm. So that was inspired by ocean.
Uh-huh.
And ocean as a place that we come from. Usually, you know. So that's underwater. I don't even know how it's called, but those could be volcanoes. Mm-hmm. But that's the source of life. Underwater construction, animals, and also the place we come from.
So these are a little different than the other ones. They seem more perforated and see-through.
Yeah, that's from another series that I was working on. Mm-hmm. And it shows how the wool can be used in a very different way, and the fabric is much more translucent. Mm-hmm. And as well with the light, it creates amazing patterns. Mm-hmm. You know, if you put the light properly, it creates light that goes through. But that's basically as well created from the wool that I dyed before. Mm-hmm. That's why we have so many colors that go through each mm-hmm. other. Yeah, and then, you know, you can actually use it in many ways. It can be even a blanket, you know, or wall hanging, mm-hmm. or whatever you feel like.
Mm-hmm. It can be a wall piece, and if you need it, you can just put it on yourself.
Yeah, I call it wearable art.
Wearable art, that's a good way mm-hmm. to put it.
So some pieces are definitely something that you can wear. Mm-hmm. Not everybody, you know, would be probably courageous enough, mm-hmm. but
this is fantastic way of using art.
Yeah, you know, When we will be in the in the village, I will be the one who makes blankets.
You never know when this time can come.
I know. Yeah, yeah. That's what I'm thinking about.